Hey, hello everyone. In this video, I'll be showing you how to create an infinite loop in C++. So I'll be showing you three ways how you can do this. So let's get started. So first, let me show you how you can create an infinite loop by using a for loop. So just type for, and inside it, just add two semicolons, and that's it. And just put curly bracket, and inside this, we will be just specifying some cout statement. Okay. So I'll just put loop something like that, and if I just now save it and execute it now. So here you can see I'm getting an infinite loop over here. And if you just add over here int I equal to 0 and I less than 10, and if I'm not adding any increment statement, okay, increment condition over here, this still will remain as an infinite loop because I will remain 0 forever and this condition will be true forever as well. So this will be an infinite loop. So I'm saving it now and compiling and run it. So yeah, same result, same infinite loop. But I think very less people use for loop for creating infinite loops in their programs. Majority go with while loop. Okay, so next I will show with the while loop. So for while loop, it's like really simple as well. Just put while one, and here you can just see out the same, I guess, see out loop, saving it, and if I run it now, yeah, same thing, infinite loop. And now let me show you a way how you can control this infinite loop and how you can use for your program or any other application. So in the first way, what I will do is I will have a int n, okay, int n v1 at first. So I'm going to have a condition like this: if you enter 0, the infinite loop will terminate, okay, like that. So here I, what I will do is I will just have n over here, and inside this I will be having cout enter n, and in the next line I will put c in n. Okay, so what will happen is that at the first iteration n value will be 1. Okay, so n value will be 1, it will come over here, this will be printed, and we will be entering n. So if you enter any value for any number, if you enter 1 2 3 4 5 6, or if you enter 7 8, that n value will be considered as true. Okay, but if you enter the value 0, means this while of 0 will be false and this loop will be getting terminated. Okay, so in case if you want to have any program or any condition, you can have that after this scene statement. Okay, so now let me just run and check this how it works. Okay, so I'm saving it and running it now. So here you can see I'm getting enter n. The reason is because while of 1 is true. So what I can enter is I will enter 5, same thing, because while of 5 is also treated as true. I will enter some big number like this. So this is also true. Whatever number you enter other than 0 is true. So now if I enter some same, okay, so what if I enter 0? I'm entering 0, and if I just now hit enter, the loop will terminate. So here you can see the program is getting terminated. So this is how you, one of the ways you can control the while loop. And another way, let's suppose say that you don't want this 0, you want some other number. Let's say you want to have 10 as your number to terminate. So in that case, just remove this, have while as 1. We'll be using while and the break statement combination over here. So here we can have enter n, that's fine. Let us have int n, okay, int n over here, and c in n. And the next line, if n equal to 10, we will have a break statement. Really simple, I guess. Same thing we are doing, but we are having a while infinite loop predefined itself, and this n won't be affecting the while loop condition, but this n value affects the triggers, can trigger the break condition. So if n value is equal to 10, this loop will be broken, okay, and the while loop will obviously getting terminated. So I'm saving it now. I am running it. So enter n. If I enter 0 now, nothing will happen because this while loop is not determined by this 0. Only n will be equal to 10, this loop will terminate. So I will just hit enter, nothing. I will put 100, nothing, 1000, nothing. And if I now enter 10 and hit enter, the loop terminates because we are having the break statement. So these are some of the ways. And another way of generating like an infinite condition, but that is not a loop basically, it's by using a recursive function. I will just show as a bonus. If you want, you can just like watch that as well. So I will just have a function, void fun be the function, and Let me just have a cout. I'll just put amp fun like that. So here inside this, I will just, inside the main function, I will just call that function. So this is like a normal function, okay? Yeah, I'm getting amp fun. So in order to make this like an infinite recursive function, what we are doing is simple. Just call that function inside the function itself without any return statement. Okay, I will just put semicolon and save it. So now what happens is that this function will be called. It goes over here, amp fun will be printed, and again it calls within that function. A recursive call is made. So again this function is called, printed, called, printed. So this goes on infinite because there isn't any return or terminating condition over there. So if I just now save it and run it now. Yeah, so here you can see I'm getting this printed many times. So yeah, so this is some of the ways you can like generate infinite loops. And I hope you would have found this video useful. Mine's a programming channel. I've done many videos in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, SQL queries. So do check them. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.